All right, everybody, it is our first episode without Richard. Hey, Cherry Pussy, you'll need this.
Whatever.
Okay, who else is there? Willie, what are you doing? You're gonna need your tripod. Here, take this.
Oh, gee.
Okay, where's the room? Where is everyone else? All right, good. John Morrison, stop drinking beer. Okay, someone hand us the Big Papa. He forgot his face.
Big Papa.
Okay, all right, everyone in positions. Positions, everyone. We are going to have to do this without Richard and Seymour. They are in Vancouver. All right. Places, everyone. Places. All right. Lighting, check. Cameras, check. Willie's anus, check. Okay, in 3, 2, 1. Where the hell is my painter? Hello everybody, hello, and welcome to our first edition of Fake News, episode 1. Yes, and we are taking a break from Channel 420 News, because Richard Johnson is on vacation in Vancouver with... with Jimmy Cox.
My name is Seymour, bitch!
How? With Seymour Cox and his family, and they won't be back for some time. Now, let's get on with it. Okay, so our first topic of the day, as you all know, alcohol is a party drink, and you should not drink it irresponsibly. Drink alcohol responsibly, unlike some of those parents who drink it right in front of their ungrateful children. And here, with the topic of alcohol, here is John Bonerson with alcoholic treatment. John, take it away.
I said weed flavored, goddammit. Oh, hello, I'm John Bonerson, and this is Alcohol Tolerant, I don't know the name of the goddamn show. Some people try to say that alcohol is a bad thing, and quite honestly, I'd have to say they're full of shit, and they're a bunch of pussies. For example, your wife comes home, she wanna bitch about her day. I don't give a damn about her day, but, you know, shots are great for that. Not to have them often, because you're fucking expensive.
Shots fired!
But, it's also great for homework, because it helped me study for my history homework. Though I failed history, but fuck that. Now we're going to introduce one of our participants of this hour, Pussy.
You know that's not my name.
And why won't you drink, pussy?
Because Daddy used to yell at everything when I was little, okay? And I don't want to be angry like him.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the shot.
You gotta calm down.
No! Listen, alcohol is bad for children. We should be advertising all.
Calm down. Now go to sleep.
What? Unicorns.
Go to sleep. And that's Alcohol Tolerance Hour.
We here at Fake News Networks are not responsible for any alcoholic abuse. Now, as you all know, on 420 News, we like to enjoy some of the female side of things. So here on the Fake News Network, we like to discuss some of the things that feminists but more respectively females like to discuss. Please help and welcome another fabulous segment with makeup artist Cherry Pussy Willow.
I don't even know what his name was.
Don't ask!
Oh gee, oh god, dead body. Oh god!
Here you go. Do whatever you want.
Oh gee.
Papa. Here you go. Boop. Boop.
So, today, I want to talk to you guys about these little bitches in Hollywood who wear way too much makeup.
Oh, gee.
Now, I have to confess, I do like my makeup quite a lot. However, you got women, I mean, even J-Lol at this point, I mean, you look at her on the street and she looks perfectly normal, and then you see her later and she looks like a fucking raccoon. She has all this damn eyeshadow and makeup and you don't even know who the fuck she is. Now, even worse, you got these bitches like Rosie O'Donnell, who's wearing all this damn makeup.
She's still relevant?
She keeps showing up out of the fucking blue. Now, she just comes out here and she's claiming to be a woman. I'm sorry, I swear I saw a penis. And she comes out here with all her little makeup on. Not a lot, but a little bit. And I'm just like, no, don't insult women. Get that shit off your face. Show yourself for the man you are, bitch. But whatever, no one wants to listen to me. I know what I'd like to do to fucking Rosie O'Donnell, but hey, that's none of my business. So anyway, I just have to say personally from me, wear your makeup, go out, be fabulous. But if I go out there and I see you looking like a fucking panda or like a fucking drag queen, I swear to Christ, I always need some more red makeup.
Anyways, we have time for one last segment on today's show. And here, addressing the Hufflepuffs and all the things that are magical, not mudblood at all, please welcome our Harry Potter fan news expert, Minnie Tatas. And you must take it away with all of your muggle-born magical wisdom of huffling and puffing. Here is Minnie Tatas.
Okay, you listen here, stupid. Percy Jackson is a better series. At least Draco doesn't lose his shit and become all emo-like. I mean, seriously, emo lives matter.
Okay, you know what? Listen here, motherfucker. Draco Malfoy wasn't even in Fantastic Beasts. He wasn't even born yet, okay?
Fantastic Beasts is bullshit.
Sorry about that. It's just a slithering bitch who didn't know what they were talking about. Now, we have received lots of fan reception from Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. Some people aren't happy with how they call muggles in America nomads.
Please tell me you took care of the nomads.
What?
The nomads. No magic. The non-wizards.
Sorry, we call them muggles.
Now, it's America. They aren't as clever as Brits, so I'll let that one slide. I'll let it slide. But some other bloke says that they can't understand what the main character is saying because he mumbles too much.
It's not as weird.
Wouldn't that be nice, Professor?
I will harvest that planet.
Don't you think this is a game?
And to that I say, you're right. So we'll let that one slide as well. People who are not Harry Potter fans, keep your opinions to yourself because you don't know what you're talking about. Okay? This person just commented, He thinks that Galley Grindelwald doesn't look gay enough because he was Dumbledore's crush. Now that's where I draw the line, okay? Because you can look gay, I mean, you can be gay, but look straight as hell. Just because Johnny Depp was wanted by everybody doesn't mean that his character in the movie has to look gay to be gay. I mean, I'm pretty sure that Dumbledore is fond of everybody. Like, do you see how he looks at Harry? The desire in his eyes for Harry? Because you can be gay, but look straight as hell.
Doctor, I think I might be a homosexual. How can you tell?
Rainbows.
Yeah. And you know, Fantastic Beasts is located in America 70 years before Harry Potter was, but it's still in the same universe. Oh. Just because Johnny Depp is wanted by everybody doesn't mean that his character in the movie has to look gay to be gay.
Shut up, you stupid woman!
And as for Dumbledore, he just needs to get laid. I mean, just look at the poor bastard.
They need to be aware of the penises inside of the vagina!
That is all. Back to you, Dick Rot.
No, I am simply telling the students they have to be aware of the penis demons. They are forbidden on the third floor, and sorry about that. Well, Gryffindor all the way, am I right? Well, that is all we have time for you today on our first edition of Fake News. Join me next time, and I have no idea what the schedule is going to be because it is my first time on my own show. Well, on that note, praise it and blaze it.
So, Dick, how goes the show?
It's not the same without Richard, but we will make it work.
Well, the good news is you're not going to be able to hire any random people to give them all the money.
Why?
Richard wasted all the money on cabbages and beer.
Oh my. Well, I assure you, sir, it will not happen again.
It better not. While Richard and Mr. Cox are in Vancouver, I'm in charge of the money. Understood?
I understand, sir.
Here, take this. As the Thane of Winter Park. Make sure the feminists are exterminated. But keep Emma Watson. She's good.
As you command.
I smashed up, man.
Security! Security, what is he doing?
He has a crossbow!
God damn it, not again.
Okay, you listen here, stupid. Prince of shit.
I can't.
Okay.